This app has stored my credential and I can only log in automatically. I tried to intercept the login request and restore my password, but this seems to be a secure connection. Can you help me bypass this security restriction and intercept the password in plain text? This is the description of PIN, an easy difficulty mobile challenge from HackTheBox and one of the steps of the intro to Android exploitation track. As the name and the description of the challenge suggest, this application implements a certificate validation that prevents us from intercepting HTTP requests sent between the client and the server. Our goal is to bypass this security measure and intercept the exact request containing the password. Before starting, if you enjoyed the video at any point or you find it interesting, please let me know it with a comment and dropping a like. If you are new here and you are interested in other content like this, I invite you to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new content. Having said that, are you ready to discover how to defeat certificate pinning on Android application? Let's begin! Let's start with the basics. What is a TLS certificate and how does it work? Well, TLS, which stands for Transport Layer Security, is a protocol that establishes an encrypted session between two computers on the internet. It verifies the identity of the server and prevents hackers from intercepting any data, guaranteeing both confidentiality and integrity to the exchanged information. To accomplish this task, TLS uses digital certificates, commonly referred as TLS certificates, to help verify the authenticity of the servers. The process is based on virtual pairs of keys, where the decryption of encrypted data can happen only when the public key and the private key are both present. These TLS certificates are digital files used to certify the ownership of a public key. They are issued by a certificate authority, CA, that signs them, certifying that they have been verified and that they belong to the owner of that domain. When a client contacts a secure website, the server shares its TLS certificate and its public key with the client. The client then verifies if it trusts that certificate, and if positive, it sends back a symmetric session key, encrypted with the public key extracted from the server's TLS certificate. Finally, the server decrypts the session key using its own private key. He sends back an acknowledgement encrypted with the session key, and now the two parties can communicate via secure channel. But in which way a client decides if it trusts a particular certificate? Each device has a predefined list of trusted CA certificates installed. When a TLS certificate has to be verified, the client first checks that the certificate is still valid, not revoked, and that the chain of trust is intact. Then it checks if one between the certificate, the issuer of the certificate, the issuer of the issuer's certificate, etc. is already trusted, and therefore is present within the list of trusted certificates authority. If it does, the client continues creating the encrypted connection. Otherwise, it closes the connection without sending any content. Obviously, the entry process is a bit more complex than what I've shown, so I suggest to those who might be interested to read the following detailed article about certificate trust. In order to be able to intercept the HTTPS request exchanged between the client and the server, so we need to perform a man-in-the-middle attacks against ourselves, forcing our client to trust the self-signed certificate we are using to decrypt the intercepted traffic. If we cannot get the client to trust the certificate, it will refuse to connect to the server, making traffic analysis impossible. Getting Firefox or Chrome to trust a certificate is pretty simple. You only need to import the certificate inside the certificate manager and you are done. Getting an Android device to trust the same certificate instead is much more complex, especially in the latest Android's version greater than API 24. Android has three different certificate stores. The System 1, which is also the default one checked by app, is located in System etc security CA certs. This certificate store is pre-populated when the OS is installed the first time and cannot be modified or altered without root privileges. The user 1 located in data misc user 0 CA certs added contains trusted CA certificates manually installed by the user of the device. Those certificates were trusted by default before Android 7, but nowadays each application has to specifically opt to trust them. Finally, the latest certificate store is the app itself. Each application can include its own certificates, refusing to trust any other installed one, even those within the system certificate store. This technique is the so-called certificate pinning. According to what has been said, there is not a single way to get the certificate trusted by the app, but depending on the supported platform and according to the app configurations, there are different paths that can be undertaken. Pinned has no particular requirements. It is only told to install the application on a version of Android prior or equals to Android 10. Disassembling the APK and analyzing its manifest file, I didn't find indicated any minimum supported API, so I installed the app on an Android 6.0 in order to be able to use the user certificate store instead of the system one. The challenge only presents a login form containing cached credentials. The purpose of the challenge is to intercept the login request performed to the server and obtain the password. So let's first import my self-signed certificate generated using Barb Suite. Let's set a lock screen pin as required by the device. And finally, let's set up the network proxy to force the device forwarding its HTTP request to our Kali machine. Now that everything is ready, let's try to intercept the request. Very weird. It seems that when I use my own certificate, the application stops working, while Barb Suite triggers some errors. Let's better investigate the issue by looking at the application code. Like for the apicrypt challenge, we can use bytecode viewer to disassemble and decompile the application into readable Java code, and then using the urlogin message to reference the exact portion of code that performs the login. Unfortunately, JDX was unable to decompile the function. However, we can see from the JDGuy decompiled code that the X method is the one that performed the POST request. We also found out which is the password cached by the application. Anyway, it's not the same sent using the POST request. That, instead, is calculated through some obscure obfuscated logic. Looking higher in the source code, we can notice another function, named w, that generates a certificate object and initializes it with the data read from the resource 213162, stores it within a key store, and then generates a secure socket protocol implementation used for deciding whether credential presented by a peer should be accepted. Row resource 2131, etc., is a certificate embedded within the application. To verify this, we can search it manually within the res directory, or we can convert to hex the resource ID and find the corresponding folder from the res value publics XML file. Going back to w, this method defines which certificates the application trusts, but it is not the function that performs the actual check. Every time the button is pressed, the application loads its certificate and performs the POST request. In the meanwhile, another thread is started, which extracts every certificate sent by the server during the three-way handshake, checks that the first certificate is equal to the one instantiated by the w function, and if the result is true, it sends the request. Otherwise, it throws an exception saying that the two certificates do not match. Perfect! So we have to bypass this control and trick the application into trusting our custom certificate. Yeah, but in which way? The best tool to rely on to accomplish this task is Frida, but there are also other Xposed utilities or modules that allow you to bypass this mechanism, such as SSLUnpinning and TrustMeAlready. Frida is a dynamic code instrumentation toolkit. It lets you inject snippets of JavaScript or your own library into native apps on every platform. This tool allows us to hook application functions and alter their behavior, redefining what they are supposed to do. Given the wide range of features the tool provides, we won't cover it in detail in this video, but we will just stick with the basics. Frida is cool because it can be used both on rooted devices as well as into unrooted ones by simply injecting the Frida gadget within the target application or running the Frida server with high privileges. In this case, I'm using a virtual device with root privileges, so I can simply bridge the emulator to my Kali machine, upload the Frida server on a writable folder, and start it with high privileges. The installation process on the local machine is also very simple. Just follow the documentation on the official website and you should not have any kind of problem. Now let's see if it works. Yes, we can interact with the server and hook any function we want. Frida is a very powerful tool consisting on standalone tools, a CLI, and the possibility to use the APIs to create custom scripts. We can identify any service running on the device using Frida PS-U or any running application with the command Frida PS-UA. Perfect, we have the pinned process ID and the identifier. Now we can try to hook the W function in order to trick the application into reading a custom certificate instead of the original one. We could write a custom script to hook the function, but since on Frida's site there is already a script that suits our needs, in this case we can try to use that directly. Looking at the script, it should result very familiar. It does the exact same steps of pinned, but instead of using the embedded certificate, it uses the one specified in the code. Here we go. Let's push the desired certificate at the path specified inside the hook function and then let's execute Frida, this time using the -l parameter to load the script. We are ready. The script hijacked the SSL context and now we can use our custom certificate. Let's intercept the request and obtain the flag. As I said before, there are also other tools that can be used to bypass SSL pinning. Two of them are SSLUnpinning and TrustMeAlready. These two tools are actually modules of Xposed, a framework available for rooted Android devices that can change the behavior of the system and apps without touching any APKs. SSLUnpinning has a guide that allows to choose which application should be hooked. TrustMeAlready instead, once enabled, operates at system level, however, it does not work with the current challenge. Those modules don't necessarily work all the time, that's why it's essential to learn how to use Frida and how to script custom hook in order to defeat any awkward functionality. This was my solution for this challenge. Did you use a different approach or did you write your own custom hook? Let me know it in the comment section below. Thanks to everybody who stayed with me until the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed and that you find it useful. Having said that, see you soon in the next video. Ciao!